Hi everyone. In today's lecture, I would going to teach you the fundamentals of knocking of genes and identification of drug targets to treat any disease or viral infection. First and foremost thing is, let us discuss a fundamental aspects of creation of animal models for pathogenicity, thereby identifying the potential drug candidates for the viral or any disease or any ailments. First, going into the basic protocol of designing of drugs, first thing is you need to create a model. These models are either you create a computational model, that is a virtual model, or a real model. Let us see what we are going to do. One thing is your computational model. Second one is your real model, that is which you place in animal subjects or in an human subjects, and you identify the effect of pathogenicity of the virus. The first and foremost thing is, to create a model, you need to know the genetic sequence of any, what you say, target. Suppose if you take, let us discuss with the basic structural component of virus. So how it attacks and what are all the basic functions. So here I'm going to show you, this is your, for example, this is your MCoV, that is MCoV, this is murine coronavirus, that is murine coronavirus, that is also called that causes mouse hepatitis virus. So this is the basic structural components. It is similar to your coronavirus of your COVID-19, which contains spike proteins, which contain M protein, which contain glycoprotein. This is your spike protein. Okay, this is a single stranded RNA. You have various other protein components present in your structure models. So how you create a virtual model is, first thing is, you should know the genetic code. So the genetic sequence, that is the sequence of your structure, you should know. Once you know the sequence, you can create the alignment of such sequence. The sequence alignment will provide you some structural alignments of your proteins, and what do you say, you have some motifs. You can identify the motif of your structural motifs. So this is your motif. The second methodology is, you create a real model. That means you go to an directly to a mouse and identify. So this is your mouse. So I am a very bad in artist. So this is your mouse model. The mouse, you identify where exactly the coronavirus infection, that is the receptor binding domain, that is RBD. For example, if you take the COVID-19, the receptor binding domain is your angiotensin converting enzyme in your lungs. So this is your potential target for your binding of your viral pathogen, especially by using spike protein. So this is the fundamental information you came to know by the preliminary studies. Whereas in your virtual model, you create a model and you study what type of the residues which are responsible for binding to your, that is your receptor binding domain. So these residues, what is the role of these residues and how they will play in pathogenicity, that is the fundamental aspects in drug design. So let us see what exactly happens murine coronavirus. So in murine coronavirus, by the researchers found out that rigidity of S2 domain of spike protein and lack of conformational flexibility of your S2 domain. That means it is rigid enough which causes the hydrophobicity of your motifs of your murine coronavirus. What happens is, in the S2 domain, so this is your S2 domain, so there is one proline bridge present in your, what you say, the S2 domain of spike protein of murine coronavirus. So this is, we are talking about murine coronavirus. Now, how you would know what exactly is present in your S2 domain, that is a hydrophobic domain, that is two proline bridges? This is done by either using in silico model, in silico, that is CAD approach, that is computer aided drug design, along with your biophysical NMR. So bio-NMR. So you will study the free antigen NMR and a receptor binding antigen NMR, and you identify that there is a group which is essential for receptor binding, that is peak session. So now, once you identify this receptor binding domain, I already told you, we have already have the genome sequence. Now we should go for knockout. What exactly is knockout is, we have a genome sequence, right? In the genome sequence, we have various nucleotides present in the sequence. Now we have to identify the portion of nucleotides, the portion of gene which are responsible for expression of your proline components. And by identifying this gene sequence, you will perform a method called as knockout. What do you mean by knockout is, you will simply eliminate this sequence by reverse engineering. So I am simply doing the reverse engineering method. In this reverse engineering, I will design. So the first step, I will only ensure that there is removal of one proline moiety. So, and I will make the gene without expression of two proline. They will express only one proline. Now I will study the effect of individual proline on antigenicity or fusogenicity. What do you mean by fusogenicity? That means the extent at which fuses with your receptor target. So the fusogenicity is reduced when there is only one proline expression. If you remove further, there is another proline, the viral pathogenicity is significantly reduced to 90%. So now, whatever the animal model we created, both by computationally as well as in the mouse model, which says that the effect of the prolines, that is conformational rigidity of a prolines which is removed, so that there is a more flexibility of your hydrophobic region. This flexible hydrophobic region cannot bind to your neuronal cells, especially in the axons of your neurons. So there is no pathogenicity. So the researchers found that the two proline moieties are responsible for binding to your receptor binding target, as well as there is profusion of the hydrophobic region from gray matter to white matter is also responsible only with the presence of two proline moieties. If you do not have two proline moieties, the demyelination, with the effect of demyelination, is also reduced. So one thing is, you here it is very clear that the two proline, that is conformational rigidity, is responsible for what you say, the progression of virus from the receptor, as well as your retrospective action of your viral pathogen from the neurons to your retinal axons. So this is a fundamental information. So we need to create an animal model. Even with the corona, we know that the COVID-19 will bind to the ACE angiotensin converting. So let us see. So now this is your angiotensin converting target in your lungs. So this is your angiotensin converting target present in the lungs. Now your nCoV with the single stranded RNA will come along with its spike proteins. Now these spike proteins are responsible for complementary binding with your angiotensin ACE2. You need to create a model what structural components are responsible for binding to your ACE receptor, and those structural components, if you are knocking out them, is there is any reduction of pathogenicity. If such pathogenicity is reduced, your drug candidates should effectively block those amino acid or residues in the proteins, so that your progression of attack, release of viral particles as well as genome may be reduced. This type of mechanism is called as knockout models. Both these are virtual models as well as real animal models. Hope you understand my lectures. If you like, subscribe and share them. Thank you.